We are starting a new regular segment every other Monday at 5 p.m. featuring apps for kids that will help them learn. Carissa Christner, a children's librarian with the Madison Public Library, who does a lot of programming, including an app story time, will be selecting the featured apps and then showing us how they work. And so she's here with her first recommendation, and I'm really excited about this because I'm excited as a parent to learn what you have to recommend.
Awesome. I'm really excited, too. So I'll start by talking a little bit about the library. We have nationwide library initiative called Every Child Ready to Read. And they have shown that there are five practices that you can do, you're probably already doing at home with your children. Those are read, write, talk, sing, and play. And of course, librarians love to tell you about books that can help you with those practices, but you know, apps are another kind of media, and they can also help with all of those practices.
And I think it's great that parents hear a librarian saying that app usage is okay.
Absolutely. I think that done in the right context and with the right usage, these can be really a great way to build up your literacy skills and also build relationships between parents and kids. So great. I'm going to talk about one app today called DipDap, and this is a great app for, it doesn't expressly teach you how to write, but it teaches kids how to, encourages kids to scribble and to draw, which is kind of practice writing.
How they start to learn.
Exactly. So
okay.
In the same way that you babble before you talk and toddle before you walk, you need
sure.
to practice writing. So I like this because it is engaging and fun for kids and for adults, no matter what level they are at with their writing skills.
Okay.
So here we have this character, DipDap. He's from the BBC.
He's cute.
He's trying to reach the stars, but he can't quite get there. And so this line has drawn us a little circle. I'm going to tap on that circle, and it takes us up, and it tells us that it thinks we should draw a rocket ship for DipDap to go to
okay.
the stars. Now, my drawing skills and my line tracing skills are pretty good, but you know what? If I was doing this with my three-year-old, I might decide to make it a little more jazzy. I might decide to color in that rocket ship.
Oh, fun.
But if I was doing it with a three-year-old, their drawing skills might not be so great. Their rocket ship
and
might
that's
look
okay.
like that. That's totally fine. So let's take this crazy rocket ship that we just drew and see if it'll still work to drive DipDap up to the stars. I think it will.
Oh, that is so cool.
This app is available on Android and iOS, just so that you know. Oh, there he goes.
And so it's showing that no matter how you drew it,
right.
it's doing the function it's meant to do.
Exactly. And it really is engaging for all ages, and I like that about it.
All ages. I want
yes.
to make sure I was going to ask you about age appropriateness.
Yes.
Okay.
I would say probably starting about age 3 and honestly, I think even grown-ups could enjoy this app.
Okay.
And that's one of the things I want to talk about is that one of the most healthy ways that you can use apps with your kids mm-hmm. is to choose apps that really build relationships instead of building barriers like screens can sometimes do. But you can snuggle up with an app the same way that you do with a book.
And so that's your parent tip for the day.
Yes.
Chris is going to have a parent tip to go along with each app that she brings to show us every other Monday. So thank you so much. And I've got to tell you that she has a great online list of her app picks for kids. She even lists the appropriate age and a topic for each one, and DipDap is the featured app right now. If you'd like to look at her list, go to nbc15.com, click on News Links. Thanks.